السلام عليكم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي رب زدني علما. Children, hope that you all are well and you are studying this subject and you are enjoying your learning. Today we are going to learn a topic of chapter number 1, that is ASCII code, Unicode and extended ASCII code. Before we proceed to the discussion, let's see what character set actually is. By the way, the moment you see your keyboard, it is composed of different characters, isn't it? Now, what is it actually? You can see the letters, you can see numbers, you can see some other characters also, like arrow keys, the function keys, the special keys, the punctuation marks. So you can see a number of keys, and all these keys together form character set. So this is one thing that you need to know, the definition, that whatever the computer is working on, whatever the computer is able to understand, that all those letters, all those numbers, all those special characters are forming a character set. Okay. Now, what is ASCII? First thing is ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. And this system was designed, was set up in 1963 for use in communication systems and computer systems. A newer version was published in 1986, and this is going to deal with 7-bit codes. Now, if I say 7 bits, it means, if you can recall something that we have studied in our conversions, that 7 bits means what is the maximum value that can be stored in 7 bits? Yes, can you recall quickly? If all the 7 bits of your byte are turned on, what is the maximum value? That makes it 127. That's great, Eddie. And if anyone asks you that what is 127 in your hexadecimal, so you can see that that will be equal to, can you make it quickly? Can you convert this 127 denry into its equivalent hex value? Okay, you have seen it here. Fine, but otherwise that is going to be 7F, because 7 bits are turned on. So if you see the start from the right hand side, combination of 4 bits makes the value 15, and 15 is represented as F. And 3 bits turned on makes 7, so that is going to be simply 7F. And these values, these 127 values, are representing the ASCII code. And they are containing the letters, numbers, and some characters that are found on a standard keyboard. And along with these letters, numbers, and special characters, there are some 32 control codes. And these are the control codes that are numbered from the beginning, the 0 to a certain to 31. And this is going to be, if I say 31 in denary, is equal to 19 in hexadecimal. So one thing that you have learned right now is ASCII code. First thing is it stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. And this is going to be a 7-bit code. And these 7 bits are going to hold the values from 0 to 127. That makes it to be total 128 values. Any questions? Okay, now this is the ASCII table. Now, if you just see this ASCII table as is present in your book also, can you observe something here? Now just see, the first column is decimal, which is shortened as DEC. Second column is hex, which is actually hexadecimal. And the third column is the character. So the same three columns are repeated in the second set, which you can see starting from 64 and ending on 95. Then we have the third set, which is dealing, this is again dealing with decimal values, the equivalent hex values, and the character value. So you can see here, starting from 32, because as I said in the beginning, that the first values, which are from 0 to 31, are control codes, which are actually non-printable. So you can see 32 in decimal is equal to hexadecimal 20. And that is basically the ASCII value for space, the space bar. Like, for example, if you want to use space bar, so the ASCII value for space bar is 32. Similarly, you can see 33 is representing some symbol. Then same goes for 34. That is also some symbol, quotation marks. Then we have 35, 36, 37, and so on going till 127. Okay. Now, one thing which if you can observe, like 65 till 90 is basically the character A, B, C, D, E, F till Z. So it means that these are the ASCII values for the capital letters. Like if anyone wants to ask you that what is the ASCII value for capital A, you will simply call from your memory and you will simply say 65, and that is the ASCII value for capital A. Similarly, if anyone asks you what is the ASCII value for capital C, you'll simply say 67, and they all are one after the other, contiguous one after the other. Okay. Now, again, some of you may have observed that similarly, we have small a, and the small a is representing is represented by the ASCII value of 97. And again, you can see they are all one after the other. Like after 97 is 98, that is for small b, then 99 for small c, then 100 for small d. Then similarly, it is a continuity, and you can go further and further till small z, that is 122. It means that you can see capital is starting from 65 and goes on till 90. And small a, the small letters are starting from 97 and then go on till 122. By the way, can you observe some other values that we use quite often? That's great, Asad. Excellent. You can see here that it's basically the digits. The digits starting from 0 and they are going on till 9. And you can see that they are basically represented by 48, 49, 50, 51. And one thing that you have observed very accurately is they all are one after the other. They all are in a sequence and they are not scattered. They all are in a sequence. So from this ASCII table, what we have learned right now is capital A till Z, small a till Z, and the digits. They all are present one after the other and they all are, you can say, grouped together to make it understandable, to make it easy for the programmers to remember and work accordingly. Now, along with that ASCII, we have extended ASCII also. And what is it? Now, you can see for yourself, extended ASCII is using 8 bits. And when it is 8 bits, it means the value is going to be from 0 to 255. And either you say 0 to 255 in denary, or you can say 0 to FF in hexadecimal. These both mean the same, because if you have all the 8 bits turned on, you can recall that that makes it the value as 255 maximum, and 0 to 255 makes it total 256 values, and they are represented by 0 to FF. Okay, any questions? And with extended ASCII, that 8th bit is going to give me additional 128 codes, and these are going to be allowing me to store the characters that are non-English alphabets, and there are some graphical characters also that are present in those 128 codes. What are they? Let's see. First thing, as you can see, extended ASCII is used sharing the same first 128 values that were present in ASCII value. And then it has some additional characters which were not present earlier with ASCII. And they, as you can see here, it's starting from decimal 128. It's shown by a certain, it's showing some character in DOS or maybe some other character in Windows, and goes on and on and on. And you can see the last value in this table is 255, and that is representing a value in your Windows environment. So it means that with this extended ASCII table, I am getting additional 128 values that weren't a part of ASCII table. I'm very much clear. No confusions regarding ASCII. You can see for yourself. This is what people told me that ASCII 7 bits means it is going to be holding the value from 0 to 127. And excellent ASCII means total is going to be 255, means 0 to 255 makes it 256 characters. And those are sharing the previous ASCII table values. They are same. And then additional values are shown in the right hand side, which you don't again have to rote learn at all. There's a very simple thing that you can see, you can remember, and then it will be very easy for you to work on. Now, there were definitely some problems. If you have understood well, ASCII has a certain number of disadvantages. What is the first disadvantage? It does not represent characters in non-Western languages, for example, Chinese. If you want to store some Chinese values, then that is not supported by your ASCII value. And that is why what comes to my rescue is the Unicode. Another one is DOS and Windows, which you observed is using different character sets, characters for some ASCII codes as well. That is also one of the limitations that is observed in your ASCII code. And that is why another code was introduced by the name Unicode. And this was developed to work on supporting the languages that were not supported by ASCII. Like it can be the Chinese language or some other languages. And you can see it can represent all languages of the world. It can support many operating systems, search engines, and internet browsers. And it is going to definitely use the same characters as are used by ASCII. But afterwards, the other values will be different in when we actually stored in Unicode, and they are not a part of ASCII table at all. One interesting thing, ASCII is using 1 byte. As you observed, extended ASCII was using 8 bits. That means 1 byte. On the contrary, Unicode is supporting up to 4 bytes per character. 4 bytes means such a huge value. So that is definitely one of the advantages that Unicode has, that it can support larger characters, more characters, which were not supported by the ASCII value. The Unicode consortium was set up in 1991, and the version that was published had 5 goals. And those were: create a universal standard that covered all languages and all writing systems, biggest advantage; produce a more efficient coding system than ASCII; adopt uniform coding where each character is encoded as 16-bit or 32-bit. Again, if you recall, 16-bit means 2 bytes and 32-bit means it will be 4 bytes. Create unambiguous encoding where each 16-bit and 32-bit values always represent the same character. They are not going to be represented by different characters. They will be exactly same. Reserve part of the code for private use to enable a user to assign code for their own characters and symbols. This feature is useful for Chinese and Japanese character sets, just as an example, that have been I have been saying since the beginning. As you can observe, that Unicode is supporting the other languages like Chinese and Japanese, which were not supported at all by the ASCII values. Just some Unicode characters for you to comprehend and remember. Characters that are used in languages like Russian, Romanian, and Croatian are represented by the Unicode, just for the sake of you to comprehend. Otherwise, again, you don't have to rote learn these at all. What you need to know is the difference between ASCII and Unicode. Very clear. I know that we are clear that what does ASCII store and what is the capacity of the Unicode. 1 byte and 4 bytes, and that will give you a very clear idea of ASCII values and the Unicode values. Jazakallahu khairan kaseera for being a part of the learning journey with me. If you have liked my video, then please subscribe my channel and do not forget to click on the bell icon so that you get the updates as soon as new videos are being uploaded. And just for the sake of making you, you can suggest to keep in the pipeline. Inshallah, I'll be uploading the calculation of file size, a very important video that is very helpful to the student. So please be a part of the learning journey with me. Stay with me, stay connected. Take very good care of yourselves, your parents, your siblings. May Allah bless you. Allah Hafiz.